So Vortex here, welcome to my review of the Creative Pebble V3. That's what I look like. They are a Minimalistic 2.0 because it's the stereo, because you get two USB-C powered speakers with Bluetooth 5. I got these because my desk is very narrow. It is basically in the same width as my monitor, so I needed something very compact. These are probably not for you if you've got a lot of space. You can get some speakers or powered monitors or something like that. But if you have a very small space or as like pictured to use it on a laptop, these should perform okay, but I have not tried them at this moment. And yeah, as full disclaimer is I bought these myself from Amazon UK. So I was not paid to do this video, and other thoughts and opinions are my own. And let's get into it. So I'm quite looking forward to these. So let's see what we get. So I'm meant to be 16 watts of peak power, allegedly. They come with a USB adapter. Should just be plug and play. I will be trying these on my PC, which is Windows 10. And see what we get. So Bluetooth 5, 2.25-inch drivers. So compared to the version 2, the drivers are bigger, and this one doesn't have any like subwoofer mode or anything. You don't need a sub. Here everywhere with clear dialogue audio. We'll see about that. Amplified audio with high gain mode. Now these are meant to be used in high gain from other reports. So use them in high, and you need to use a USB 3 connector. So to type C to USB A if you don't have a type C port. I can try that on both. So manual should be in there. Shouldn't need to use that. And these are connected, so yeah, I'm gonna unwrap the bubble wrap and see what it's like. So straight onto this one. This is the left one, as you say, 2.25-inch. There's the base of information. There says L. Focus. The passive radiator on the back, which is a good sign. It's a protective film. I'll take that off in a bit. And yeah, so that's the left one. Good to see it's got like the passive radiators. So basically that kind of acts because there's no vent. So this is the right one. Click to power on, power off. That's a button for Bluetooth. Very straightforward. High and low gain. I'll see what that's like. There's R for right. Again, you can see it move. It's a passive radiator. I'll take the film off in a bit. And you can see here, it terminates to type C. So yeah, I'm gonna get this all set up and see what it's like. Before try mode, you get this paperwork if you're interested. If not, you can just skip it. So, not sure what that is. Get that. Worldwide warranty, which is there. Worldwide compliance. So basically legal things and a quick start guide. So this should be very straightforward to use, but I'll open it up. You can always pause it if you have to. So overview here. So high gain solid blue, low gain is solid green, aux mode, volume knob, rear view. So you can plug something into the back as well. Passive radiators, I was correct, as you can see there. So Bluetooth mode, connected pulsing, pairing's flashing. Low gain, you see it's pulsing and flashing. Toggle between the source, so the Bluetooth button goes between USB audio, Bluetooth and aux in. Now, when plugged into a PC or Mac for the first time, the PC will be in USB audio mode by default. When plugged into a power source that does not support USB for the first time, it will go to Bluetooth by default. So that's how you connect it to a laptop, for instance, Bluetooth through a phone, aux in as well. So you can connect it to a phone to do the signal, and then through a power socket for basically to power it. I look like master reset. So 8 watts RMS, peak 16, 2.25 built on passive radiators, A2DP profile only, operating range, input 5 volt 2 amp, signal to noise ratio of 75, frequency response there, connectivity, operating temperatures there, and yeah. Other information, and then on to sounding in German. So yeah, let's try these bad boys out. So this is how I've got it set up on my PC. The monitor, as you can see, is a 27 inch panel, for example. And yeah, so that's the right unit. It's on, so you can see the blue light. Off, there's the click, on. To be brutally honest, half power, it's loud. It does have passive radiators on the back. Ignore the cable mess because I will tidy it up. Obviously one cable connects to the other. Very straightforward. And yet I like it because I'm physically sitting there in my chair. And that's the purpose I want, is my desk is as wide as the monitor. So I have no space for speakers. But while I'm sitting here looking at the monitor, which is Audacity at the moment, they don't block my vision at all, so for me they work perfect. So you can see from the size, this Logitech keyboard is just a standard size keyboard, and that's just what they look like. So for my use case, it does work perfectly fine. Obviously the button here is, you can switch to Bluetooth, and when it tries to pair it will pulse. So, and that's it. So in the next clip, I'll just do a kind of sound demo as a rough kind of demonstration, really. But it's not really a true, you know, it's not really a true figure what they sound like. But while, before I get to that, I might as well say my experience of these is actually not too bad at all. They actually sound better than I expected, and actually get louder than I expected. So half power, like I said, which is about there, is realistically more than you ever need. In Windows, it's 16-bit 48 kilohertz, so that's what it comes up as. Bluetooth on these is SBC. The codec, again, works fine, shall we say. There's no aptX or anything like that. But yeah, the kind of cool, build quality is good. It's yeah, not too bad at all. But before I even get to the actual sound kind of sample, is the sound quality is kind of on the warmer side. These aren't really bright sounding speakers. They perform perfectly fine, but they are on the warm kind of sound. Technical performance is actually not too bad. Everything sounds clearer than I kind of expected. Obviously, if you've got the space, you know, you'd get bigger speakers, but I have no space, so this is my I have to compromise. But if you got more space, you can obviously get something bigger and better. But for just over £20, these are not too bad at all. To be honest, I'm really quite happy with them. They perform better than I expected. But everything sounds kind of clear. As you say, they're missing upper treble. But these are just over £20 when I bought them, which is very inexpensive. And the build quality on them is actually very good. There is a 3.5 in the back, which I've shown you in the unboxing. I'll show you again. You can see it there. The auxiliary in, obviously there's the passive radiator, and when it's loud enough you can actually feel the desk vibrate, so it's pretty good. And yeah, so the next clip will be just a sound recording, and yeah, that's it. I'm always trying to see through your flaws, I know that you got so much more to give. You made a real mess, but I miss you though.
Cause I can go to sleep when I'm alone again. Say you wanna fix our problems. How long should I be waiting? Feels like I've had too much of drama. But I'm not ready to give in.
So yeah, onto the actual conclusion of the Creative Pebble V3s. As you've seen them, you know what they look like in action, and you've actually heard the sound sample, which is obviously from YouTube, so I don't get in trouble. But yeah, I think on the whole, they said the build quality is actually very good. For what the cost is, I think I paid around £23 for, obviously from Amazon UK. They normally go sometimes like high 20s. But for my use case, they work really well. I'm quite happy with their sound. They sound kind of better than I expected. But obviously, if you have more space, then bigger speakers, monitors, you know, whatever, are probably a better option. But like me, these are designed for this limited space, or if you want a minimalistic setup. I think these work perfectly fine, and for the price, I do recommend these. But bear in mind, if you've got more of a budget and you've got more space, there is much better options. And yeah, I think that's it. So yeah, anything as usual, want to let me know, just post in the comments. And yeah, thanks for watching and take care.